Yo, yo, yo! What up, guys, and welcome back to another one. Oh, boy, howdy, just woke up. What a beautiful morning. But before we get into today's video, I need to let y'all know the Ducks T-shirt of the month. Check it out. This is June's Ducks T-shirt of the month. This season, y'all, we are giving away another XL duck boat and Mud Buddy motor as well. The boat actually comes complete with a duck blind on the top of it already as well. Over a $20,000 boat, y'all. But we're giving everybody a chance to win that boat. Yeah, we gave one away last season. We're doing the same thing this season. And your boy's gonna have one all to myself. That is the one that we will be giving away. It's my boat. Yep, it's not here yet. We should have it in a couple weeks. But I just wanted to let you guys know that we are giving another one away this season. All you gotta do is sign up for the Ducks T-shirt of the month to have a chance to win that bad boy. I will link the Ducks T-shirt of the month at the top of the description down below. But I'm gonna get out of these clothes actually, go put my camos on. Let's go hunting. Well, check it out. We are out here, and believe you me, it is a lovely, beautiful, beautiful day. Couldn't have picked a better morning to do this. But we have a little storm action, a little overcast, and yeah, it's perfect. A little bit of breeze to keep the mosquitoes off you. Now, I'm telling you, when we get back in the woods here, it is going to be Mosquito City. I didn't wear a long sleeve shirt today, so yeah, wish me luck. I'm going to strap up the old GoPro, grab the old 12 gauge, and we're going to get huffing it here. Holy smokes, guys. So we got an electric fence here. You can actually hear it going tick. Yeah, it's arcing out on the ground. Check this out. Look at that. I don't know if you guys can see that right there, but it is. Yep. I'm going to go ahead and fix this bad boy. Pull these up off the ground just a hair. There we go, that fixed it. Sorry, got y'all on the GoPro here, but I thought that that was pretty interesting. If you ever hear that ticking noise and you know you're around an electric fence, check and see if it's arcing out on something. Because if it was really dry out, guys, that could actually start a fire pretty easily. Again, just helping the farmer out. The farmers are usually busy. When we get to go walk around on their property and go just hunt and search around, there's a lot of stuff like that that we can find to help out that farmer. Just like last time, I found that calf back here that wasn't doing so good. I called him and he's like, hey, thanks, Bobby. I really appreciate you telling me that. Just like that, I could have started a fire. Guarantee you, he would appreciate it. A lot of you guys are always like, Bobby, how are you such good friends with the farmer? Bobby, how do I get permission on land? Well, doing stuff just like that. Guys, be their friend, be their neighbor, help them out. Ooh, there's a starling. I say we have starling. He is dead. We gonna have starling today, boys. I had to pull the trigger on that one. Here's that feed bunk I was talking about, and that's where he came. He came right to that feed bunk. I'll tell you what though, that old Federal High Bird load right there, plus the old full choke, reached out and touched that guy. Woo! I'll be darn. Well, this is a first for me. So this is actually a juvenile starling. He's very young. As you can tell on the beak, he has a black beak still. The adults, they all have yellow beaks. And plus, look at his back. He's completely brown. I mean, completely brown. When he crossed over the top of me, I was like, ooh, that's a starling. Heck yeah. And he landed. I'm like, let's take him. So I shot him and I walked up here and I'm like, man, that looks like a juvenile. I've never got to see a young starling because you know me, I started starling hunting with Jordan not too long ago. And Jordan's actually been talking about, he's like, hey man, there should be a lot of juveniles coming out to play here in small packs. And sure enough, this is the first one that I've seen this year. We're coming out of spring, so there's gonna be a lot of younger birds flying around. Pretty neat. But one in the bag, still got you on the GoPro here. I know we're after the Eurasian collared dove, but I had to squeeze the trigger. We have to have us a decent lunch today, guys. I mean, come on. But if you're liking this video, you got to hit that thumbs up button for your boy right now. Go ahead and put our little juvie starling in the bag. It's kind of the only reason why I brought my backpack. Was to carry any keel that I get. So, on the board, woohoo! All right, guys, like the last time we were here, I showed you all these dead trees. Now, this is where the Eurasian collared dove love to sit. Dove in general love to sit in huge or small, doesn't matter the size, but dead trees. Now, with the gunshot that I already had, I'm sure this area is gonna be toast for about 10 minutes. So we're gonna go to the other part of the farm and push it back this way. We're gonna have to be really quiet. So if I'm not talking in the woods, I'm sorry. I'm gonna be really quiet because I do wanna get it done today with the collared dove. Man, the mosquitoes are horrible, like I said, but I'm watching these birds fly and man, there's tons and tons of small groups of starlings everywhere. This is the area where I seen a lot of the collared doves this morning when I was pulling in. Well, I've searched around the back part of the farm here. We're gonna go up to the dead tree area. Now this is where we should get some action. What's gonna happen, guys, is if I find one perched on a tree, I'm basically gonna have to scare it off so it gets in flight and then I can take my shot. So let's cross our fingers, hope that we can get it done here. It's always a challenge doing this stuff. When you pick a particular species going into something like this, it can get real tough. All right, here we go, boys. Wish us luck here. This is not gonna be easy, I can tell you that. I've seen them here, but to actually pick one out and get to shoot it in flight, it's gonna be an undertaking, I can tell you right now. There's a squirrel. Squirrel is open. That boy is dead. Yeah, buddy. Well, we got a mixed bag today, fellas. Squirrel just opened. It was June 1st, actually. Opened June 1st. Check it out. Check it out. There he is. Look at that. A little heavy shot for the squirrel, I will admit that. Kind of knocked him into outer space. But yeah, squirrel's been open for a handful of days. This is how these solo hunts go. This is why I love these solo hunts so much, is we come out here, we have a species in mind that we're gonna target, but you never know what you're gonna get into. We got a starling, and now a squirrel, baby. There he is. Got him right in the back end, right here. Look at that. Good looking squirrel right there. Wow. Heck yes. Yeah. We're in business. Now again, guys, I didn't even think that this is gonna happen. Just like on the last solo hunt, the rabbit hunt, I didn't think that we were gonna end up shooting a cottontail rabbit. And sure enough, one came darting out, and in my mind, I always have my little black book, you know, in my mind, and it's like, is that species in season right now? You always have to know what's in season right now, because squirrel, like I said, just opened up June 1st here in Kansas. So we're gonna have us some squirrel stew today. Actually, I don't know how we're gonna cook the squirrel, but it's gonna be good. Well, wow, wow, wow. It's always nice to be pleasantly surprised. You know what I mean? No collared dove today. We've completely, with the two shots that we've taken now, we've completely scared anything out of this area that could possibly have been here. So I think we're gonna call it quits on the hunting part today. Let the area settle down here. This guy though, he just came out at the right time. He wasn't even scared of me. He seen me, he started trotting around, and like I said, in my head, I was just like, oh, it's squirrel season. Boom, had to take him, boys. So again, if you guys are liking these solo hunts just like this, give your boy a big old thumbs up. Let's go home. Let's cook us up some lunch. Well, we decided to mix it up a little bit. Just got off the phone with Jordan. Y'all know Jordan. Y'all love Jordan. Jordan was like, dude, I haven't cleaned a squirrel in so long. Bring it out to the shop. We'll clean it up and get it all done up for you. I'm like, heck yeah, I'm in. Because I've necessarily never cleaned a squirrel. I actually just cleaned a rabbit yesterday for the first time, and it wasn't bad. Squirrels shouldn't be any harder, I wouldn't think. But Jordan, he's probably a magician at it. Jordan processes deer, cattle, chickens, pigs, anything that off the farm, he will clean. Anything off the farm, pretty much. So, and deer. He does do deer. But here we go. We got the squirrel and we got the old juvenile starling here.
It's
everywhere.
Yeah, that hind leg's a little broken.
And the stuffing out his side isn't natural.
Yeah, shouldn't have all the stuff hanging off the side. Jordan grabbed him and he goes, dude, he's a little squishy. And and here's the deal, guys. I'm not just a savage where I want to take the biggest gun possible and destroy whatever comes in front of me. But today we had the 12 gauge with a full choke and with high bird ammunition. And so when I hit the squirrel at 20 yards or 15 yards, whatever we were at, it pile dried that squirrel. That squirrel became a flying squirrel in about 0.2 seconds. Sorry. He got a little jacked up, man.
Gotta make it hard.
If I would have known that squirrels were even in the vicinity, I probably just would have took the 410 or something like that. Maybe a 22. If you guys want to see a 22 squirrel hunt, let me know. But here, me and Jordan have actually tried squirrel hunting a couple times, and we have had very slim luck lately. So it was literally a miracle.
Slim means we didn't kill any.
Slim luck. I mean, didn't even see a squirrel. It was a miracle that this one actually came and popped up out of nowhere. But I'm gonna let the magician here with the magic hands do the talking and the work. What do you got going on here? You're doing a little differently.
Oh, this is kind of how we do rabbits here. See, there's just stuff everywhere.
Oh yeah, I'm still lead shot in the legs and stuff.
Oh yeah, pretty much just opened him from the ankles, got his legs hung up there.
Nice.
And just sort of open him back. There's lots of different ways to do it, but if I have the stuff to do it this way, might as well. I mean,
right. Yeah, you already got the entire rig going here. I had no idea how to clean a squirrel. So before Jordan hit me up, I'm like, yeah, better YouTube how to clean a squirrel. So the way that I was going to do it until Jordan offered was I was going to do the old boot heel technique where they actually cut right underneath the back of the tail. You step on the tail with your boot and you just literally drag the skin off, kind of like a rabbit, like I did yesterday with the rabbit.
Yep.
I would say we got to not show all that because this video will be demonetized if we show all that. Basically, the squirrel is torn up. The full choke with the high bird, 12 gauge. It was a little too much for the squirrel. I gotta say that. Again, if I knew I would have been hunting squirrel today, I probably wouldn't have taken the 12 gauge. So we're gonna get this thing all cleaned up. We're gonna get it all cut up and done. I wanna do everything possible not to have these videos demonetized. A lot of you know that YouTube does not like gruesome footage, even if it's you cleaning your wild game that you just shot legally. So, 1 second. What all you got going on here, Jordan?
I have a... Listen, we're shaping that pigeon that we did.
Yeah.
There's probably more actually edible because it's bigger, but this thing's messed up. Is a squirrel?
Yeah,
It's still a squirrel.
Was a squirrel. This is the back half of the squirrel. Yeah. Because the choice of shot and shell, provided by Federal Ammo, it just crushed this poor squirrel to smithereens. So we were only able to harvest the back end of it.
Yeah, the rest of it was destroyed. The guts had gotten through the front of it. It wasn't pretty.
Oh, doing some chopping. What'd you do to that old starling right there? Check him out.
Well, I plucked him, but I thought I'm going to cook him in half. Maybe I'll get a little bit better cooked.
Gotcha.
And then it's easier to tell who gets to eat what part. So.
True.
Look at the little luncheon buffet we got going on here.
This here is an appetizer platter prepared by Bobby Guy Films and prepared by myself, of course, Jordan here. So, yeah, let's see what we can get going.
Oh, you don't do the old Ziploc trick. You do the 5-gallon bucket trick.
Yeah, had a little bit left over from some chicken that I seasoned earlier, so want not, waste not.
Yep. Oh, boy, look at that bad boy right there. Well, we are back here behind the shop, and he's already got the old grill fired up. Check it out. Oh, boy. Oh, yeah, that lens is like, oh, Bobby, get me away. It's hot. So a lot of you know I bought a new camera. This thing right here, this contraption, it didn't used to be a contraption. Now it's a contraption, and I can get real close to things because the lens is a wide lens. So if it looks different, if the latest videos have looked different, it's because of that.
Oh, yeah. How's she looking?
Not too bad.
Not too bad at all.
Smells nice.
Have you ever ate starling and squirrel together?
No, not together.
Not together.
It was a hard sell to get me to start on starling. I like squirrel. A little bit tougher, typically. I've had them both, but together? Maybe two bad things makes a good thing.
Well, we are done here. The starling is ready to go.
Nothing?
Check it out, though. Is it cool enough to eat?
Oh, yeah.
You going to take the first bite, or do I need to?
I'm going to skin it because I didn't do an awesome job of plucking it, so a couple feathers here and there.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
But, well, how bad could it be?
Can't be that bad. Probably pretty good. I'm just diving in. Oh. Thank God you seasoned it so heavy.
That was the strategy.
But
I don't hate it. It reminds me a lot of Dove, though. You can definitely tell it's a lot less gamey than the bigger birds were.
Yeah. Makes me want to go and really taste the meat. Yeah. Starling still sucks.
Yeah.
Your seasoning, the seasoning is phenomenal.
I mean, it did its job, but
yeah,
you can only put so many coats on a turd.
Yeah, yeah. Second time eating starling here. Well, actually, no, take that back. This is my third time eating starling. And it just doesn't get any better, really, any which way you cook it, to be completely honest.
Cool down.
Alrighty. I'm looking for a comeback with the squirrel hair. I'm looking for something to rejuvenate the taste buds and get me excited. We just pulled them off the grill. They are done. They're looking great.
It's hot.
Yeah, it's that seasoning is, it's spicy and good. But rabbit was really good. I'm guessing squirrel's going to be about the same.
Pretty close. I mean, they're done totally different styles, so they're both going to be good. They're just going to be way different than each other.
Grab your piece, partner up, saddle up. Ooh, they look good though, don't they?
They look funky fresh.
They do look funky fresh. All kinds of funky and fresh. Oh. Okay. All right. Hold on. Oh. Oh, God. Yeah, there's a bone. You weren't lying. I got bone. Dadgummit. Pretty tough, like, to get it off, right?
It definitely could have used a couple days in a nice, like, tender quick or something.
I got some bone.
It's where it's, like, the outside layer is where the tough is, because the inside
part. Oh, yeah.
I wonder if I seared it too hard to start out with, and it made it a little hard.
Well, I do know one thing. My initial bite was bones.
Are you eating sunflowers or squirrels?
Literally, bones. I chomped it up, so I got bone particles everywhere. Yeah. So, that skin layer, that outside layer, mm-hmm. It's kind of tough to get in, right? It's like, you really gotta...
Yeah, go for it.
You got a Tyrannosaurus Rex it, you know. But, pretty darn good.
I'd eat it again.
Pretty darn good, not gonna lie. Well, it is very, very comparable to rabbit. But, cooked on a grill, a lot different.
Yep. Frying it, put in a crock pot, and douse it with gravy.
Oh yeah, oh wow. Yeah. With a little bit of mushrooms. Mm-hmm. I think if we cooked it like that, it'd probably be a lot more tender.
Yep.
Right? If we sauteed it with some mushrooms, some gravy.
Sear it real nice.
Yep. That's what I'm thinking here. I'm thinking squirrel and rabbit needs to both be cooked that way.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah. Well, my mouth is sort of on fire, dude. Every time we use your seasoning, it's like, it's so good. But there is an after effect, which means your lips are going to be tingling and a little bit numb due to the peppers that you put in there.
A little bit of cayenne pepper
in there. A little bit of habanero in there. I know how you roll. But big shout out to Jordan for having us out here at the shop to film, to season, to cook, to prep all the wild game. And like I said, if you guys are liking the catch, clean, and cooks, you got to let us know down below because we do have some more coming your way. But thank you all for being here. Make sure you subscribe if you haven't. And hit that little notification bell down there wherever it is. It'll notify you when your boy uploads. But we will see you on the next one. Peace.
I've been getting laid back. Baby, you should know that. I don't need your criticism, pessimism. I've been keeping it on the DL. Got a girl that keeps it real. And it's on a need.